National Educator.
Student, I am Teacher Mary. Today we have our second lesson in biology. We have our topic cell physiology and our subtopic division. So this is a continuation from where we stopped last time. And in the last lesson, I defined the term division as the movement of particles from a region of high concentration to a region of low concentration. And then we said that division is a passive process that does not require energy, but as long as concentration gradient is there, division will still take place. So for our today's lesson, there are only two objectives that I want us to achieve. There are only two objectives that I want us to achieve for our lesson today. So by the end of the lesson, learner, you should be able to explain the factors affecting division. You should be able to explain the factors affecting division, and you should also be able to state the role of division in living organisms. So those are the only objectives that we have for our lesson today. So we are picking from where we stopped last time. So like I've said, from our last lesson, division, we said, will only take place across the diffusion, will only take place when diffusion gradient arises or when division gradient occurs. So which are these factors that affects the rate of division? So we start with the factors affecting the rate of division. So we have our first factor there, diffusion gradient. That is one factor that affects the rate of division, diffusion gradient. So what is it? This is the difference in concentration of molecules between a region of high concentration or between a region of low concentration and a region of high concentration. Dear student, if you remember our last lesson, where we talked about detecting a leaking gas, and we said you smell that gas from far. So by the time that smell reaches you, then it will first be highly concentrated where the gas or where the gas tank is. And then the particles will move until they get to where you are. So that difference between the region where these particles are highly concentrated to a region where they are already concentrated is what we are referring to as diffusion gradient. And therefore, diffusion gradient therefore becomes a factor that affects the rate of division. So here we are saying that the greater the diffusion gradient between the two points, the higher the rate of division. The greater the diffusion gradient between two points, then the higher the rate of division. So that is our first factor that affects the rate of division. Then we have our second factor that affects the rate of division. We have the thickness of the membrane. So we said division takes place in air and also in water. So diffusion taking place in water, we can use a dialysis tube or a Fisking tube or a Fisking tubing, the one that I demonstrated last time. I hope, dear student, you can still remember that. So we have the particles diffusing across the membrane or across a membrane. So if this membrane is that thick, then the particles diffusing across this membrane will take a longer time. But if we take, for example, our membrane to be that thick, it is narrower now, and then we expect the molecules or the particles diffusing to diffuse faster. So in the thickness of the membrane, then we are saying this, that the thicker the membrane, the lower the rate of diffusion, because the distance that is being covered by the diffusing particles or the molecules is higher. But the narrower the membrane, then the faster the rate of diffusion.